Hey dear viewer, let's start episode 10 with my weekly rush of blood. Of all the monsters I could have gotten at the start, I get Erut. This rush of blood is not going to go well. Not that they are that tough, but fighting them without adrenaline, that doesn't make the fight any easier. But I can't be bothered wasting an adrenaline pot here. Despite of the rough start, I did manage to complete 18 waves. And I didn't get too many easy monsters. I got no Muspa even. Good thing there wasn't an overabundance of Glacors and Tormented Demons either, so that's good. That'll have helped. And the rewards? Some rune items, those are nice. But those shards of Armadil make it great, of course. Now let's check out that clue from the Skeletal Horror. Ooh, an Armadil Crozier, I like that. And the rest is pretty good too, so I'll definitely keep it. Now for the aquarium clue, a Bandos page. I don't see a single reason why I would reroll this one. It's even better than the previous clue. Time to get back to Araxi. And this time I'm using magic. By the way, this is the first time ever I'm taking magic there. So honestly, I'm quite scared. The reason why I decided to take magic this time is because Ryza Hawkeye has informed me that with magic you have an increased chance to get the Fang. And well, the Fang is all I need for that Noxious set, which is at the moment my number one priority. And to prove even more that I'm not used to taking magic there, I forgot my runes! I'm so glad you can still use abilities without having runes. That actually could save my life. And it did save my life. I got the kill. It was a tough fight, but I'm glad I survived. I'm really proud of myself for this one. What? Another eye? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I took magic because I was sick of always getting an eye. And what do I get? An eye. Pfft, that's unbelievable. These things only happen to me. Irony, oh irony. I still can't believe it. Not a pheromone, not a leg part. Not a web, not a fang, but an eye. I bet people have rage quitted for less. Oh yeah, and I got this drop at kill 771. Wouldn't that be great if I got a fang at kill 777? Keep your fingers crossed, guys. 7 kills done, and I'm calling it quits for today. Other than the eye, which I do love as drop, because while it's rare, I also love the Hydrix ball tips. And that Draskillian fragment. Those herbs and seeds are all great as well. Also, I liked fighting Araxi with Mage today. That was a lot of fun. So once again, a big thanks to Ryza Hawkeye for actually making me try this. So it's jackpot time. I'm about to hit 777 Araxi kills. Assuming I don't die, of course. So, is it going to be a fang? Does 777 really mean jackpot? Let's find out! Oh, it doesn't. What a shame. I was really hoping for something good here. At least this proves that RuneScape isn't a casino. Well, it isn't anymore. But let's carry on. Yes, so I just died. And I pretty much rage deleted that recording. Because I died to an auto attack. How more shameful can it get? And it was just on phase 2. But yeah, I'm calling it quits for today. So this is what I got from 8 kills. I do like the massive amount of herbs I got. I always love those. Alright, I just got a spider leg middle. Now I believe I have 2 middle legs and 2 bottom legs. So I really need to kill Araxi using path 1. And I got this at kill 786. And you're not seeing the rest of the drops because I accidentally deleted that clip. But yeah, at least you can still see it in the chat box. So that's always a great backup. This is my 10th kill of the day. Since I started using magic, I haven't killed as many yet in one day. And I barely managed to get that last kill. So I may have to rethink using magic when Araxi is at a higher enrage. I get hit way too much. Anyway, the loot today was great. I mean, I can't complain when I get a leg part. And that Triskelion fragment is awesome as well. I see people hating on it, but I love those kind of things. Those runite ores and those hydric bolt tips also stand out from the rest, so I'm glad with those as well. Borg dropped me this present, an elite clue. You know I can't resist those. But a sub 200k clue, I'll have to reroll that. Still sub 200k, but I get an Armadale page. And I can assure you that those are worth a whole lot more than 200k. So, this is a great reward. And that reroll was an absolute success. So yeah, I'm dead again and I don't get it. I clearly clicked to move away from the acid wave. But my character didn't move. I really don't understand. I guess clicking once isn't good enough anymore. So yeah, because I died, I only did 9 kills today. And this is what I got from the last 8 kills. Because I forgot to reset the drop lock before my first kill. And once again I get some Hydrix bolt tips and runite ore, so I guess that makes my time worthwhile. Also, I've been using magic at Araxi for 4 days now, and it appears that I use a whole lot more food. When I range, I sometimes still have like 10 rocktails left at over 200% in rage. So that's definitely a clear difference. Also, I feel that my magic attacks miss more often than my ranged attacks. But in some cases, I do feel like the DPS is a bit higher. I have noticed some faster kills, and that's definitely because you're able to utilize Combust more effectively. When a Raxor is on you, it's so much easier to deal double damage with Combust. So from now, I'll mix it up a bit. When the minion path is open, I'll use magic, and otherwise I'll use ranged. I believe that's a pretty good combination. It finally happened. I have started raids. And this is my very first attempt at Durzac. I'm even wearing Void for this. Well, just so I could get on a team, basically. The kill definitely went much better than I expected. And that's probably because I was on a pretty good team. Everyone seemed experienced. The loot I got was pretty good, but nothing special was in it, so I rerolled. Because you never know, I may get a codex or I may get an armor piece. And I had the option to reroll anyway, so I may as well take advantage of that. So yeah, the first Durzac kill is done, and I'm definitely going to keep on killing him. I really want those abilities. After killing Durzac, I still had a lot of time left on my Yak. So I decided to use that remaining time at Araxi. And I only managed to squeeze out 3 kills from that time. But I'm also calling it quits for the day. Sadly, the loot isn't anything special. But what can you expect from 3 kills? Sure, I could have lucked out, but I didn't. On to my second visit to Durzac. And for some reason, it was a bit tougher to get into a team this time. Last time with 0 kills, I was able to get in a team in 10 minutes. But now it took me over half an hour. And the kill didn't go as smooth as the first time. But I would say like 5% less smooth, because it still was far from hard. But let's see what loot I get. Ooh, an effigy. That looks enticing to keep. But still, it's just an effigy. It only rewards XP. I kind of wonder too, how many of you would keep this effigy, and how many of you would reroll it? Post what you would do in the comments. And like I said, for me it's just an effigy. So since I'm at raid primarily for the codexes, I'll choose to reroll. And look at that! Out goes the effigy, in goes the ability codex. I can't believe it! In your face, Araxi! Durzac knows how to treat me. After 2 kills, I already get what I want. I'm really glad. Just 2 kills, whoa. Now, what to do with it? I could sell it since they're worth a lot. And for the abilities, I could buy them with T-Sai as well. What to do? I'll have to give this some thought. And here you see, I have my ability book in my inventory. And I've only killed Durzac twice. Look at that price, nearly 22 million. That seems so nice. Then again, I'm not desperately in need of money. I've also consulted my friend Spiff Capt about this. And according to him, Corruption Shot and Corruption Blast are really worth unlocking. So, since I don't really need the money, And considering that the abilities are really good, I have decided to unlock an ability. But which, shot or blast? Well, I'm better with ranged than with magic. Also, I own the Noxious Bow and Dual Ascensions. When I'm fighting Durzac or the Queen Black Dragon, I tend to use ranged as well. And at Araxi, ranged is also the easiest, in my opinion. So, I guess Corruption Shot would be best for me to unlock. And of course, because of that, I will now use ranged instead of magic at Araxi. But another thing, I basically started raids solely for this ability. And I got it after my second Durzac kill. But now that I got the hang of it, why should I stop? There are still other useful abilities to unlock. Like now, I really want that Corruption Blast. And you know, the armors are great too. Now that I have Corruption Shot, I'll probably perform better at raids too. I've killed Araxi 5 times today, and those were my first 5 kills with Corruption Shot. At first, I needed to get used to that new ability bar setup. But I didn't really have a lot of problems with it. And I gotta say, I love Corruption Shot already. It's so very useful at the minion path. First you take care of that mirrored back spider or that pulsing spider, and then you can get back on Araxi. And Araxor, I mean. You basically shoot him with Corruption Shot and that spread to the minions, half killing them in the process. And again, I didn't get any exclusives from Araxi today, but I did get 2 uncut onyxes and onyx bolts. And those are really super items to get. Those runite ores are a nice addition as well. And that's 6 more Araxis killed. And the loot today is really good. Hydrix ball tips, uncut onyxes, 412k coins, a Triskelion fragment, and many herbs. I mean, I really can't complain here. Also, an ancient effigy again. That's quite a rare find here. Too bad I can't reroll my drops here. Just like in raids. I swear I would have gotten a fang on that reroll. Oh well, one can only dream. Just as in last episode, I mainly focused on Araxi. And again, just like in last episode, I didn't get one step closer. All I need is still that one fang. But I did get a step closer to making my 5th spider leg. Now all I need is 2 more top legs. And yeah, now I'm in possession of 4 spare eyes. So, if anyone needs an eye transplant, I can help. Oh wait, surgery isn't a RuneScape skill yet. So maybe I should hang on to those eyes just for when that happens. Next week I'll be focusing on Araxi as well. Maybe then I'll finally get that fang. And who knows what else I might get. So definitely check back next time. That's it for now. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the next video.